Hey everyone, Jamie here, and every week I spend hours hunched over the crafting table, which eventually leads to pretty stiff muscles and joints. So imagine my excitement when I saw that the most recent fan request was a crafter's dream craft, the type that actually relaxes you once you're all done making it. Get ready as I show you how to make your very own bath bombs. Let's do it, girl. Okay, so in order to make your own bath bombs, you're going to need 1 cup of citric acid. I could only find this stuff online, which is why I grabbed such a big bag full. You might want to save yourself the time and hassle and get yours that way too. You're also going to need 1 cup of Epsom salt, which you can find in most pharmacies, 2 cups of baking soda, food coloring, essential oil or natural perfume, and 1 cup of base oil. Now, just like with my homemade Nutella, you can use any type of oil here, but remember that you're not going to be eating this thing, you're going to be bathing in it. So just make sure that those ingredients are something that you don't mind on your skin. A bath bomb's purpose is to create a relaxing bath with a soothing scent, pretty color, and fizzing bubbles. Now, as far as supplies go, you'll also want to nab a bowl, a jar, a whisk, a spoon, and any mold you want to shape your bath bombs. Since it's fall, I chose these turkey molds, but you could use cupcake liners, ice cube trays, ornament balls, and more. All right, bath bombs away. Step one. The first step is to mix all of your dry ingredients in a bowl. Drop in your baking soda, citric acid, and Epsom salt, and then mix them all together using your whisk. The next step is to mix your liquid ingredients together in a separate container. Pour in your main oil and then add a few drops of essential oil and food coloring. Now, I've never had a bath bomb leave a ring around the tub, but if you're nervous about using food coloring for that very reason, then go ahead and follow my DIY soap tutorial. That way you can create your desired bath bomb just using soap colorants. Either way, shake up your ingredients within the jar or swirl them all together using a spoon. Once you have both your dry and liquid ingredients ready to go, it's time to mix them together. Now, the whole point of a bath bomb is to disintegrate within bath water, right? So then it would make sense that if your dry ingredients got too wet, then that fizzle reaction will already start to occur. That's why you'll want to very slowly pour your liquid concoction in very short increments into your dry mixture, all the while stirring with your whisk. I personally ditched the whisk and used my hands to make sure all the dry ingredients packed into the moisture. I also recommend this technique because when you're all finished, it kind of feels like the beginning of a manicure or a day at the hand spa. Is there such a thing as the hand spa? Anyway, this wasn't the case with me, but there could be a chance that using citric acid and Epsom salt could irritate your skin, so feel free to put on rubber gloves if you're worried about that sort of thing. Keep on whisking or whirling or ringing around your ingredients until it's between the consistency of a crumbly cookie and damp sand. Step 4. All that's left to do is place your mixture into the mold using a spoon or your fingers. You want to pack the mold the same way you'd pack a measuring cup when you're baking. Press as much as you can, as firmly as you can, scraping away any excess for a smooth finish. Once your mold has been filled up, place it in a dry, cool place overnight. If you try to take out your bath bomb any sooner, then it's most likely going to break apart. When finished, carefully pop out your creative creations and enjoy your handiwork. To display your masterpieces, you've got a ton of options. You could follow my dipped mason jar tutorial to style up a glass jar to put your bath bombs in, or you could wrap them in seasonal aluminum foil, or you could just tie them up with a pretty bow. I threw my leftover bath bomb batter into an ice cube tray, and the pieces even look great in an everyday small jar. Plus, bath bombs make the absolute best holiday gift as well. I had the amazing privilege of being able to attend the HGTV Handmaid's Friendsgiving party, and every crafter there had the most delicious beverage and food items to share, so I think they got a kick out of being able to take home a craft that they could enjoy after the party too. And now you've got yourself the gift that gives. Just don't forget to hang on to a few of them in order to treat yourself for later. This DIY is truly the bomb. The bath bomb. Nailed it. How did you make your bath bomb? Tweet me at Jamie Petito, Instagram me at Hey Jamie, or just tell me all about it in the comments below. We did it, girl. I'm Jamie and you're on girl.com. For more DIY crafts just like this one, don't forget to subscribe to our channel. I had the amazing privilege of being able to attend HGTV Handmaid's Friendsgiving event. So long to say. Hey everybody, Jamie here. So every week I spend hours hunched over the crafting table, which eventually leads to pretty sore joints and muscles. Jaints. New word. J-A-I-N-T-S? Jamie's Jaints? New show.